Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Dr. Jagriti, second year postgraduate of NRA Medical College. I'm going to present a case of ocular toxoplasmosis. I have no financial benefit. Introduction: ocular toxoplasmosis is a disease caused by Toxoplasma gondii through congenital or acquired wounds. Congenital is by transplacental hematogenous spread, which manifests as bilateral central retinochoroiditis, leaving scar, which is an incidental finding. Acquired infection is obtained through contaminated feces or soil, sporulated oocysts, or by consuming undercooked meat or pork. Recurrent episodes of inflammation occurs when tissues rupture and release phagocytes into normal retinal cells. Case report: a 21-year-old female presented with defective vision and protus in left eye since 1 week. Her unaided visual acuity on the day of presentation is 6x6 in right eye and counting fingers at 1 meter in left eye, having no improvement with pinhole. On examination, her right eye was normal. In left eye, anterior segment was quiet and posterior segment showed vitreous cells of grade 2 and active retinochoroiditis lesion needed to old choroidal scar in the macular region. Fundus of left eye showed single grayish-white lesion with irregular margins of 1 disc diameter in size with inferior hyperpigmented area of half disc diameter above the fovea, suggestive of satellite lesion. Another isolated, well-defined, well-circumscribed lesion of hyperpigmented lesion of half disc diameter is seen temporal to the actin lesion, which is suggestive of old choroidal scar. Linear streak-like folds are seen extending from the temporal margin of the optic disc to macula, suggestive of internal limiting membrane folds. As the fundus pictures shows the classical fundus picture of toxoplasmosis, it is suspected and investigations of toxoplasmosis gondii, IgG and IgM antibodies are done, which came up positive. ESR, chest X-ray and Montreux test were done to rule out tuberculosis. Differential diagnosis include viral retinitis, tuberculosis, rubella, acute retinal necrosis, syphilis, and sarcoidosis. Treatment given is started with oral antibiotics 24 hours prior to steroids. Tablet azithromycin 500 mg once daily for 2 weeks and tablet sulfamethoxazole plus trimethoprim in a combination dose of 800 plus 160 mg twice daily for 4 weeks and tablet prednisolone 40 mg in a tapering dose of 10 mg for every 5 days till it reaches 10 mg. Tablet omeprazole 40 mg once daily and then follow-up is done. This is the picture of left eye showing before and after treatment showing hale lesion adjacent to the old scar. Visual acuity in left eye improved from counting fingers at 1 meter on day 1 to counting fingers at 3 meters with pinhole 636 partial on day 3. After 4 weeks, it is 618 partial and after 8 weeks, it is 66 partial. Discussion: ocular toxoplasmosis is a common cause of infecto posterior uveitis in immunocompetent individuals with cats as definite host and humans as intermediate host. Acquired toxoplasmosis presents with satellite lesions and as headlight in fog appearance, which consists of focal necrotizing retinochoroiditis with overlying severe vitritis. Conclusion: prompt diagnosis and early treatment improves vision, although it is a self-limiting disease. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Jagriti. Yes.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Jagriti.
I think we've got Dharmesh on the line.
Yes.
Dharmesh, are you there?
Yeah. Hi, Swana.
Hi. Hi, Dharmesh. Hi. Hi.
Good to see you. Yeah.
Good to see you. Jagriti, that's a very well put up case. That's very well documented. And I think the line of management at our simple level in a case of ocular toxoplasmosis is pretty straightforward. Supriya, you have anything to add on? I think it was a simpler case that she showed, and yes, it was a straightforward treatment for that particular case. Though we've had cases of toxoplasmosis which have had a different variety of presentations also with severe vitritis, and you know, this didn't have much vitritis. I think it just had a focal lesion which was very straightforward.
Right, right. Yes. That was a very good visual improvement. 3x60 to 6x was a very good improvement. Yes. So, Dr. Jagruthi, what do you think was the cause for the 3x60 in the beginning? Was it just the subretinal fluid around the lesion? Was it retinitis involved?
There is vitritis and along with a fresh lesion is seen with floppy margins seen at the posterior pole of the macula.
Okay, okay.
Only thing that I thought was that the vision 3x60 didn't document for the lesion was not really involving the fovea. It was pretty far away. And the fundus picture also didn't show so much vitritis, Supriya. So
yes,
considering that fact, I think the vision was probably pretty less, you know, compared to what the picture of the fundus picture that was showing. Absolutely. Was the fundus picture taken a little later or was the initial picture only, Dr. Jagruthi?
Initial picture, ma'am. Initial picture and later picture was also taken. Compared between the pictures before and after treatment.
Okay.
Okay, sure.
All right.
Can I make one comment, ma'am?
Sure, sure, Sunita.
So I just want to ask Dr. Jagruthi whether the immune status was done or not, because the reason of this question is normally we don't do in a classical toxoplasma case, many times we don't do immune status checkup. But in this case, the vitritis was slightly less than what we generally see in a toxoplasma case. So less vitritis means some kind of immunocompromised situation going on. So was something done? Was HIV tested or any other cause of decrease in immune status?
She is an immunocompetent individual only, ma'am. There is no immunosuppressed state and other routine bed investigations and viral investigations were done, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Dr. Dharmesh is there, sir. Would you like to make some
comments? No, it's fine. But as Sonal has correctly pointed out that, you know, if this region would have a retinal surgeon expect different pictures, you know, either fovea or lots of vitritis. It's such a less region.
Yes, yes.